Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for turning up. We're a small but select group, and hopefully we'll have an interesting discussion about what is a very important and very underreported issue. I've just reported on this for The Economist, and I was very surprised to find that running for office in Japan is extremely costly. Candidates in the Tokyo metropolitan election, for example, deposited 600,000 yen each with the authorities, which they forfeit if they get less than 10% of the vote. In general elections, the deposit swells to 3 million yen per candidate in the upper house elections, and 6 million yen per person in proportional PR representation districts. By far the world's largest financial bar. Utsunomiya-sensei was just telling me that the system was copied from the UK in 1924, but whereas the UK has dropped its deposits and many other parts of the developed world have sent them to zero, Japan's is still very high. Utsunomiya-sensei is one of many critics who say that setting the cost of entry for elections so high favors the big political parties, the unions, and industry lobbies, and helps ensure that smaller political parties, and new entrants are shut out of power. Our two speakers are going to discuss this very important issue. Kenji Utsunomiya is an attorney of law. He is ex-president of the Japan Federation of Bar Associations, and he has twice run for Tokyo governor. I was just reminding him that I interviewed him about 3 years ago, and he didn't remember. So he knows at first hand the cost of running for election. Yuzuru Kamoda is an attorney at law. He's with the Saitama Sogo Law Office. They are in the middle of a lawsuit in the Tokyo District Court, suing for a change to this law and hopefully its abolition. The fifth hearing, I believe, is in September. September, that's right. So do give them your best attention. Utsunomiya-sensei is going to talk first, and our translator today is the very brilliant Mary Joyce. Thank you.
それではまず私の方からお話をします。
Good afternoon, and first I would like to make some introductory remarks.
私たちは今日本の選挙供託金が憲法違反、違憲であるという裁判を提起しておりまして、私はその供託金違憲訴訟の弁護団の団長をしてます、弁護士の宇都宮健二と言います。
So we are currently carrying out a lawsuit claiming that the election deposits in place in Japan are unconstitutional. My name is 宇都宮 and I am the leader of this legal group, legal team.
この裁判の原告は2014年の12月の14日に行われた第47回衆議院小選挙区選挙において立候補しようとしましたが、300万の供託金を用意することができなかったため、立候補届を受理してもらうことができず、立候補することができなかった男性、現在57歳の男性です。
And the plaintiff in our current lawsuit is an individual, a man who is now 57 years old, who attempted to stand for election in the 47th House of Representatives single seat constituency election of December 14, 2014. However, at that time he was unable to prepare the deposit required of 3 million yen. And for this reason, his notification of candidacy was not accepted and he was not able to stand in the election.
この裁判は国政選挙に立候補しようと思っても原告のようにお金がない国民を立候補できなくさせている、我が国の選挙制度における選挙供託金の違憲性を問う裁判です。
And the purpose of this lawsuit is to question the constitutionality of the fact that even if someone is willing or wishing to stand in an election, in a national election, if in the, as in the case of this plaintiff, they are not able to have the financial means to stand, then, it is preventing them from standing in elections. So the fact that this amount of money is required of candidates is against the constitution.
非選挙権すなわち立候補の自由は選挙権の自由な行使と表裏の関係にあり、自由かつ公正な選挙を維持する上で極めて重要であり、我が国の憲法15条1項により保障されている権利です。
And the right to stand for election or the right to candidacy is an important aspect which is also enshrined within the Constitution of Japan. In paragraph 1 of Article 15, it states that the people have the inalienable right to choose their public officials. And so this is showing the constitutional aspects of the freedom of standing for candidacy.
このことは最高裁判例の1968年12月4日の最高裁の大法廷判決でも認めていることです。
And this has been acknowledged in the verdict of the Grand Bench, which was on the 4th of December 1968.
また憲法44条ただし書きにおいては、両議員、まあ、すなわち参議院、衆議院ですね、両議員の議員およびその選挙人の資格は、財産または収入によって差別してはならないと定めており、選挙供託金制度はこれらの憲法の規定に違反していることは明らかです。
And further in regards to the Constitution, in the proviso of Article 44 of the Japanese Constitution, it states that the qualifications of members of both houses and their electors, shall be fixed by law. However, there shall be no discrimination because of property or income.
この裁判は我が国の世界各国と比較しても異常に高い選挙供託金制度の問題点を明らかにし、個人の財産収入の他かに関係なく誰もが国政にチャレンジできるようにするために選挙供託金制度の廃止または大幅な引き下げを求めるために提起されたものです。
And therefore, we are carrying out this lawsuit in order to bring attention or bring to light the fact that the election deposit in Japan is extremely high in comparison with other countries around the world. And furthermore, that anybody, regardless of their property or income or the size of these, should have the right to take the challenge of standing in a national election. Therefore, through this lawsuit, we are calling either for the complete abolition or for a significant reduction ofThe election deposit system.
日本国憲法全文では日本国民は正当に選挙された国会における代表者を通じて行動するとして議会制民主主義による政治制度を謳っています。
The preamble of the Japanese Constitution states that we, the Japanese people, acting through our duly elected representatives in the national diet, so putting forward this aspect of representative parliamentary democracy as a system listed in the Constitution.
議会制民主主義の下では多様な国民の声が政治に反映されることが求められていますが、選挙供託金制度により立候補の自由が制限されることになれば、多様な国民の声が政治に反映されにくくなり、議会制民主主義は形骸化してしまいます。
And, under a representative parliament democracy, it is thought that the diverse voices of various people of the country should be reflected in politics. However, by having restrictions on people standing for a candidacy as a result of the election deposit system, this means that it becomes more difficult for such diverse voices to be represented within the parliament. This also damages that system or really makes the system, well, empty in a way.
したがって選挙供託金制度の廃止または高すぎる供託金の大幅引き下げは健全な議会制民主主義の発展のために求められているものです。
Therefore, the abolishment or significant reduction of the currently required extremely high election deposit would be a way to also further develop a healthy representative parliamentary democracy here in Japan.
我が国では貧困と格差が広がっており、原告のように国政選挙に立候補しようと思っても高額な供託金を用意できず立候補できない人が増えています。
In Japan, the issues of poverty and also disparity in terms of economic capacity are growing. And therefore, this means that such as the case of the plaintiff in this case, those people who are not able to have the financial means to prepare the very high election deposit means that there are also many more people who are not able to stand as candidates in the election.
厚生労働省が2017年6月の27日に発表した 2015年における我が国の相対的貧困率は 15.6% となっており、国民の6人に1人が貧困状態に陥っています。
According to the statistics announced on June 27 of this year in regards to the 2015 relative poverty rate of Japan, these are the statistics by the Ministry of Health, Labour and Welfare. This is at a rate of 15.6% of the population, meaning that one in six of the people of Japan are now in what is seen as poverty.
また一人親家庭の貧困率は 50.8% となっており、2世帯に1世帯が貧困状態に陥っています。
Further, in regards to single parent families, their poverty rate is seen to be at 50.8%, meaning that one in two of such households is now under the poverty line.
相対的貧困率とは、全国民の10日可処分所得の中央値の2分の1未満の人の割合を言うものであり、2015年の10日可処分所得の中央値は年244万円なので、年122万未満が貧困ラインということになります。
And the relative poverty rate, or the way that it is calculated, is seen as people whose equivalent disposable income is at less than one half of the national median. Therefore, if we look at the 2015 figures, where the equivalent disposable income median was 2.44 million yen, this means that people whose disposable income was at 1.22 million yen are those that are seen as being under the poverty line.
我が国の貧困と格差拡大の背景には、我が国の脆弱な社会保障制度と非正規労働者、働く貧困層の拡大があります。
In the background of this expanding poverty and economic disparity in Japan is issues related to the fragile social welfare system and also the situation of non-permanent workers, or those known as the working poor, and the expansion or the increase in such people in Japan.
非正規労働者は2000万人を超え、今や全労働者の約4割となっており、非正規労働者が増加する中で、年収200万円未満の低賃金労働者は9年連続で1000万人を超えています。
In regards to the number of so-called non-permanent workers or temporary workers in Japan, it has surpassed 20 million people throughout the country, and this is around 40% of the total workers in Japan. As this number is continuing to increase as well, in the past 9 years running, the number of low-income workers whose annual income or annual salary is less than 2 million yen has been over 10 million people each year for these 9 years.
貯蓄が全くない貯蓄ゼロ世帯は全世帯の 30.9% に上っております。
And the number of households that have zero savings at all is said to be more than 30.9%.
貧困と格差が拡大する中で、生活に困窮する人が増えて、生活保護利用世帯は163万世帯、生活保護利用者は213万人に上っています。
And within these circumstances, the number of people who are having difficulties in their everyday lives is also increasing. The number of households who have had to start to use social welfare is up to 1.63 million households, and the number of individual users of the system is 2.13 million people.
貧困状態に陥っている国民にとっては、自分の年収を大幅に上回る高額な供託金を準備するのは極めて困難であります。
And for those people in situations of poverty, if they were to want to stand for election, the idea of having to raise an election deposit which is more than their annual income is of course extremely difficult.
日本は異常に高い供託金、選挙供託金制度によって、立候補の自由を奪われた人々が大量に存在する社会となっています。
Therefore, as a result of the extremely high election deposits, Japan is, well, the system in Japan is removing the freedom to stand in election for many people in such circumstances.
我が国の選挙供託金制度は、1925年の衆議院議員選挙法改正法、いわゆる普通選挙法から始まっております。
The current election deposit system in Japan was introduced at the time of the so-called regular election law or the House of Representatives election revision law of 1925.
この時に同時に成立した法律の中には戦前の数多くの人権弾圧事件に利用された治安維持法があります。
And another law which was passed at the same time was actually the Public Order and Police Law, or generally known as the Peace Preservation Law, which is the law which has become very well known for being responsible or being utilized for various human rights abuses during this pre-war period.
普通選挙法で選挙供託金制度が導入された表向きの理由は、売名行為者または泡沫候補者の立候補を抑制し、選挙の混乱を防ぎ、選挙を誠実厳正に実施するためと説明されてきました。
And until now, the explanation which has been given for the introduction of this election deposit system has been to prevent the candidacy of or publicity seeking candidates or frivolous or minor candidates in the elections in order to avoid confusion or disruption during the election and in order to ensure that they are implemented in aSincere way.
しかし、供託金の額、当時は2000円、当時の公務員の初、初年俸の約2倍と高額であったことからも明らかなように、無賛政党、無賛者の議会進出を抑制することが真の目的でした。
However, by considering the fact that the deposit required at that time was 2,000 yen, which was actually around double the amount of the first year income of a public official, meaning extremely high at the time, the actual reason for the introduction of this system was in order to suppress standing for candidacy or the progression into the parliament of so-called proletarian parties.
この高額な選挙供託金制度は戦後においてもそのまま残存し現在に至っているのです。
And this system of extremely high election deposit has remained in place even after the war and is still the current situation today.
そもそも売名行為者や泡沫候補者を排除するか否かは国民主権を重視するのであれば有権者の判断に委ねるべきだと思います。
And if the purpose is or the question is about whether to exclude so-called publicity seeking or frivolous candidates from standing, if we were indeed to look at the sovereignty of the people, this should be something to be made by the decision of the voters.
昨年、2016年の5月の26、27日、日本の伊勢島で、G7 サミットが開かれましたが、G7 参加国のアメリカ、ドイツ、フランス、イタリアでは選挙供託金はゼロです。
In 2016, on May 26 and 27, the Isesima G7 summit was held here in Japan. If we look at the G7 member countries of the United States, Germany, France, and Italy, all of these countries actually have zero election deposit.
またイギリスの供託金は約7万円、カナダは約8万円です。
Or the cases of the United Kingdom has an election deposit of around, or the equivalent of 70,000 yen, and Canada around 80,000 yen.
これに対して、我が国の供託金は衆議院参議院の小選挙区では300万円、比例区では600万円と極端に高くなっています。
However, if we compare this to Japan for the single state constituencies of both the House of Representatives and Councillors, it is 3 million yen, and for proportional seats, it is 6 million yen, so extremely high in comparison to these other countries.
アメリカやドイツ、フランス、イタリアなどで供託金をゼロにしていることにより、選挙が混乱したということは伝えられていません。
Furthermore, we have not heard any reports of confusion within elections as a result of abolishing the deposit system or making the required deposit zero in the case of the United States, Germany, France, and Italy.
それから、列国議会同盟 IPU のパーラインデータサービスによると、OECD 加盟国のうち22カ国には供託金制度がありません。
Furthermore, if we look at the Parline database of the Interparliamentary Union or the IPU, it is said that 22 of the OECD member countries do not have an election deposit system.
供託金制度のある国は日本を含む13カ国ですが、日本の供託金額は供託金のある国の中でも突出して高くなっています。
There are 13 countries, including Japan, which do have an election deposit system. However, looking at the amount of this deposit, we can see that even within these 13 countries, the Japanese required amount is extremely high.
高すぎる選挙供託金制度は規制政党や規制政治家に有利な制度となっており、大量の世襲議員を生み出す要因にもなっています。
As a result of this extremely high election deposit system, this is meaning that the elections are to the advantage of existing political parties or already existing politicians, and it is also one of the reasons which is leading to such a high number of second generation politicians in Japan.
現在の日本の国会議員の3割以上が世襲議員であると言われています。
It is said that actually more than 30% of the parliament members in Japan today are actually such second generation politicians.
政治家が家業となる事態が生じているのです。
So this is leading to a situation where politics or being a politician is becoming, well, a family business.
世襲議員の増加と低所得層の国民からの立候補の自由の剥奪は国政選挙の投票率の低下を招く要因ともなっている上、多様な国民の声が反映されにくい国会となっており、政治の劣化、議会制民主主義の劣化を招いています。
As a result of this election deposit system, this is meaning that not only there is such a high number of second generation politicians, but also it is meaning that the freedom to stand as a candidate for those people of low income is being deprived in Japan. This means that it is much more difficult for the voices of diverse representation of the population to be reflected within the Diet, and it is also leading to a damaging effect on the quality of the politics and of the system of representative parliamentary democracy in Japan itself.
以上で私のお話を終わらせていただきます。
Thank you very much.Kamoda-san, can I ask you to keep it brief if possible? Do you have questions? Thank you.
供託金違憲訴訟弁護団で事務局長をしております埼玉総合法律事務所弁護士の鴨田ゆずると申します。
Good afternoon. My name is Yuzuru Kamoda. I am the Secretary General of the lawsuit in regards to the election deposit system, and I am an attorney at law at the Saitama Sogo Law Office.
日本の選挙供託金の金額は選挙の種類ごとに異なり、また時代とともに値上がりしてきています。
The amount of the election deposits required in Japan differs according to the form or the type of election, and it has also been increasing with the years as well.
お配りした資料を1枚めくっていただくと、その金額の変化が書かれています。
And within the materials distributed today, if you turn the page, you can see a list of how this has increased over the years.
1925年、供託金ができた当時は2000円でした。
At the time of this system being introduced in 1925, it was 2000 yen.
その50年後の1975年、100万円に値上がりしています。
And we can see that 50 years later, in 1975, this had increased to 1 million yen.
1992年に300万円となり、その25年後の現在も300万円の状態が続いています。
Later than that, in 1992, this was when the amount was raised to 3 million yen, and this is as it stands today.
また、選挙ごとの供託金の金額は次の通りです。
And the amount also varies according to the type of election itself as follows.
国政選挙では比例区が600万円、選挙区が300万円です。
In national elections, for the proportional seats, it is 6 million yen.
都道府県知事は300万円。
And 3 million yen for prefectural governor positions.
それ以外の選挙は選挙の規模により供託金の金額は小さくなっており、町村議会議員選挙のみは供託金が0円です。
And the amount required for the election deposit decreases accordingly to the so-called size of the election itself, as you can see in the list here, going down to the last listed is for local assemblies in towns or villages where there is no deposit required.
先ほどの宇都宮弁護士の裁判でのこちらの主張に関して2点ほど付け加えさせていただきます。
I would like to add just two points to what Mr. Utsunomiya has mentioned in regards of the purpose of this lawsuit.
まず第1点目は、2001年に韓国の憲法裁判所で2000万ウォンの供託金が憲法違反だという判決が出ているということです。
And the first point I would like to raise is actually in 2011 in the Constitutional Court of the Republic of Korea, there was actually a verdict that the election deposit of 20 million won was actually unconstitutional.
韓国の判決では2000万ウォンという金額は庶民層や若者世代を代表する者が国会に進出できなくなるため立候補の自由を侵害しているというふうに判示しています。
And within the verdict of the Korean Constitutional Court, it states that the deposit requirement of 20 million won is excessive and would ultimately prevent candidates who represent the poor and the younger generations from taking office in the National Assembly, meaning that it violates the right of potential candidates to hold public office and voters' freedom of choice.
この2001年の韓国憲法裁判所の判決の内容は今の日本の選挙供託金にも当てはまると考えています。
And we believe that the contents of this verdict from the Korean Constitutional Court can also be applied or is also valid or relevant to the current Japanese election deposit system.
補充の2点目ですけれども、選挙供託金制度を設けなくても署名という代わりの手段があるという点です。
And the second point is that as an alternative to the election deposit system, there is also the potential system of petitions or signatures.
諸外国の選挙制度を見てみますと、選挙供託金制度はないものの、立候補に一定数の署名が必要という国があります。
If we examine the election systems of other countries outside of Japan, we can see examples where there is no election deposit required. However, a certain number of signatures must be gathered in order to stand for office.
ドイツ、デンマーク、ハンガリーなどの国は供託金は設けていませんが、立候補に際して署名が必要です。
For example, in the cases of Germany, Denmark, and Hungary, they have systems where no election deposit is required. However, a certain number of petitions or signatures must be submitted by the potential candidate.
私たちは供託金を用意できない人に対しては、それに代わる措置として署名などの手段を設けるべきであって、財力、私力で立候補を断念することのないような制度にしていくべきと私たちは考えています。
So we believe that such alternative measures should be put into place in Japan also for those people who do not have the economic means or the property means, for example, to raise the currently required election deposit.
以上です。
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. If you don't mind, I'll just bag the first question. I'm wondering what's the reason why this system has... I've just been looking at...the notes here, Kamoto-san's notes, and the deposit has steadily increased, as he said. Is that bureaucratic inertia that keeps it, keeps this deposit, or is there a political strategy behind keeping it so high?
まず司会の方から一つ質問させていただきます。この年にこの金額が増えてきているという話があったんですけれども、今でもこの制度がまだ維持されているということは、まあ、官僚的な、まあ、変化がないということだけなのか、もしくは、まあ、何か政治的な戦略などがあってこの、まあ、制度そのものが維持されているというふうに思われますでしょうか。
まあ、私は今の制度というのは規制政党や規制政治家に極めて有利な制度で、新しい市民政党が政界に進出していくのを妨げる参入障壁になっていると思います。今の安倍首相は規制改革、岩盤規制をドリルで穴を開けるということをいつも言ってるんですけど、この選挙制度の規制に関してはむしろ規制がますます強化されているんじゃないかと思います。
I believe that under the current system, or the current system itself is advantageous to the already existing political parties or politicians. It is in their favor to be maintaining this. It is also serving the role of preventing new parties or citizens' candidates and so on from standing in elections as well. If we look at statements made by Prime Minister Abe, he is always saying that he will, you know, drill into the current system, drill through to change various regulations and so on. However, if we look within the field, of regulations regarding elections rather than being drilled into or being changed. Actually, the case is that they are becoming stronger.
Thank you. Okay, well, we'll throw it open for questions. Anybody who would like to ask a question, if you would show your hand, please. And if you would come to the mic, please, and tell us who you are. Thanks very much.
Hello. This is Yasu Kamai from TMS Japan. Probably this is a question to Kamoda Sensei. David appointed, wanted to know why the deposit has been constantly increasing, and I especially pay attention to the fact that in 1994, the deposit for running for the national seat of the proportional representation seats was doubled in 1994 from 3 million to 6 million. And I wonder, what was the reasoning of the authority doing this, doubling the deposit?
こちら鴨田先生にお伺いしたいんですけれども、先ほどの表の中で、そしてデイビッドさんの話の中でその年々増えているという話があったんですけれども、1994の数字を見ますと、比例区の場合はその年に2倍に上げられた、300から600に上げられたということがこの表にあるんですけれども、その時の説明といいますか、その理由というのはどういったものだったんでしょうか。
比例区の600万円というのはこの時初めて創設されたものです。それ以外は全部選挙区に関するものです。
And so this was the first time for this proportional seat system to be introduced at the time of 1994. So this was when it was set at 6 million. Until then, it had all been at the equal amount of 3 million.
Just can I?
Yeah. But it was always the Zenkoku running with the whole nation, and it was 3 million. It was, wasn't it?
全国の方は300万だったんでしょうか。94年以前にあって全国の制度の方は。
全国の90ここに書かせていただいたのは衆議院選挙。国会議員の衆議院選挙の選挙にかかる供託金のみを書かせてもらいました。
So this, the list here is only showing the amount for the House of Representatives in regards to, the amount.
I see. So how much was it for running for the 全国 all nation?
全国の場合は供託金はいくらだったんでしょうか。
全国区はあれ参議院。
おそらくそれ参議院のことをおっしゃってると。
So that's in regards to the House of Councillors.
Am I right in saying that the biggest leap was between 1969 and 1975 when the amount tripled? It went from 30万円 to 100万円. That's a bigger leap.
数字を見ますと94の上がりというよりも69年から75年の間3倍に上がったということが最も大きな変化というふうに、この表を見て思うんですけれども、それは正しい理解でしょうか。
はい、そうですね。参議院についてなんですけれども、
So first in regards to the House of Councillors.
1956年から、20万円ですので、そこからは、衆議院の2倍の金額でずっと推移してきました。1956ですね。
So first of all, from 1956 it was at the amount of 200,000 yen.
はい、62年は30万円。
And 300,000 in 1962. 69
年60万円。
600,000 in 1969.
75年200万円。
And 1 million in 1975.
で、82年の時に、200万円で衆議院と同じになりました。
And in 1982, it was increased to 2 million, which became equal to the House of Representatives at the time.
で、92年の時は参議院のみ比例区がありましたので、その時600万円になってます。
And in 1992, it was only the House of Councillors which had the system of proportional seats, and at that time it was, or it became 6 million.
それで1994年の時に衆議院も比例区ができましたので参議院と同じにして600万円というふうになりました。
And then it was in 1994 when the proportional seat system was introduced also in the House of Representatives, and this is when it was increased also to 6 million in accordance with the House of Councillors amount.
Understood. Thank you.
ありがとうございます。
Thank you. Any more questions? If you have a question, please put up your hand. The gentleman at the back.
Thank you. Leo from Waseda University. The question goes from election deposits. Where do the money usually come from? Are they coming from individuals or from interest groups or lobbyist groups? Thank you.
あの早稲田大学の学生なんですけれども、その供託金を集めるという時にそれをどこから集めることが通常でしょうか。それは一般の方々から の, あの、まあ、寄付という形で集めることが多いでしょうか。それとも何かあの産業のロビー活動をしているグループだったりそういった産業の団体などから集めることが多いでしょうか。
これはあの政党によって違うと思いますけど、あの ちなみにあの私は2回都知事選に出てるんですけど、あのその時の供託金は300万必要でしたけど、基本的にカンパですね、寄付で集めてます。
How that is raised depends quite a lot according to the political party. If I use, for example, my case, when I ran twice in the gubernatorial elections here in Tokyo, the 3 million yen which was needed to stand in each of those elections was raised largely from individual donations.
ただ大きな政党はその果たして個人が集めてるのか、政党の方からそのお金を供給しているのかってあの提供しているのかっていうのはちょっと内情はよく分かりませんけど、まあ、大きな政党特にまあ政権政党なんかはかなり立候補に際しては党の方からそういう選挙活動資金が提供されているというふうに聞いてます。
Particularly in the case of large political parties, and particularly those who are, for example, forming part of the government, of course, we do not know the individual or the details within the parties themselves, but it could be considered that rather than individual donations, the parties themselves are putting forth or providing the funds for the election deposit in many of these cases as well.
で、その政党の資金の一部の資金になっているのが日本では政党助成金制度というのがありますので、それはあの政党 の, あの国会議員の数によって、助成金が支給されている。
There is also a system in Japan for support for political parties from the state as well, which according to the number of seats held in the diet by that party, there is also financial support provided to the political parties as well.
もう一つはあの政党に対するさまざまな市民や団体の献金です。
And there is also, of course, various donations made by groups or organizations and citizens and so on to political parties as well.
日本の最大の経済団体であるあの経団連という組織がありますけど、ここは政治献金を集めて、その8割以上を自民党に献金していると聞いてます。
So if we look, for example, at one of the largest economic groups in Japan, the Keidanren, they are also gathering various funds for political donations, and around 80% of their funds are donated to the Liberal Democratic Party.
そして政権を取ろうと思ったら衆議院議員が今475人ですので、少なくとも過半数を当選させないと、政府を組織できませんので、巨額なあの供託金が必要になります。
And if we were to consider, for example, a political party wanting to gain the or become the government as well, when we consider that there are 475 seats in the House of Representatives, well, in order to gain a majority of that number of seats, you can also see that it requires an enormous amount of election deposits to be put forward in order to form a government.
結局はあの今の日本の政治の状況は供託金も含めて巨額な政治あの選挙資金を集める政党でないと政治権力を掌握できないという制度になっていると思います。
And so we can see that the system of election deposits, but also other various aspects of Japan's current political system, means that unless the party is able to raise significant funds in this way, it is not able for them to take a position of power within the parliament also.
小さな政党がいつも苦労するのは供託金を、候補者の供託金をどう準備するかということが大きな課題になっています。
And one of the major challenges or struggles faced by small political parties in Japan is how to raise this election deposit in order to stand for candidacy.
The criticism that I received when I wrote my piece for The Economist was that other systems have different ways of making you pay. The American system being.A very good example. You know, okay, it's free to run in elections, but there are enormous costs, other costs to running in elections. Would the two professors like to answer that, two lawyers, professor?
以前、エコノミスト誌の方でこの問題について記事を出したときに、その時に言われた批判の一つはですね、例えばアメリカの場合は供託金そのものはないということになるんですけれども、それ以外の形でその選挙をするためには非常に大きな金額のお金が必要になってくるということがアメリカの場合ではありますが、そういったその供託金以外の選挙のコストなどというのは、先生のお二人はどういうふうにお考えでしょうか。
私の経験は基本的に都知事選の場合はほとんど寄付で、集めた寄付でもって選挙活動をやったんですけど、もちろん選挙活動に必要な資金というのは供託金だけではないんですけど、まず供託金を用意できないと立候補することができないわけなんで、その立候補する権利っていうのを そこからスタートしないと、選挙活動、以前もう行えないので、スタートラインで一定の供託金を用意するっていう、しかも高額な供託金を用意するっていうのは特に経済的に余裕のない人にとっては非常に厳しい、ハードルになっているんじゃないかと思います。
In my personal experience, for example, standing in the gubernatorial elections in Tokyo twice, of course, I also experienced that there are various other funds which are required to run an election campaign other than the election deposit. And it was also individual deposits, donations from people which I used for the campaign at that time as well. However, the fact that this deposit is required to even stand as a candidate in the first place, and that without having the financial means to raise this deposit in the first place,means that it is also depriving people of the right to stand as a candidate in election itself, the right to even go to this very first starting line in the election, even before getting into the issue of the funds for the election campaign itself. So particularly for those people who are not do not have great economic means and so on, the fact that they are prevented from even standing as a candidate is a matter of freedom or rights before even considering the cost of the election campaign itself.
私の経験をちょっと知っていることをお伝えしますと、今緑の党というのはヨーロッパではかなり の 国政で議席を持って、一部は政権に参加するような政党もできているようですけど、日本の緑の党は2013年の参議院選挙に比例区で10人の候補者を立てて選挙をやったんですけど、その時は供託金1人600万ですから、10人立てれば6000万の供託金が必要だったわけです。ただ選挙結果一定の得票に満たなかったので、6000万円の供託金が全額没収されてしまったわけです。それでその次のに衆議院選挙、それから直近ではその後、昨年参議院選挙があったんですけど、おそらく国政選挙には緑の党は立てられなかったんじゃないかと思います。そういうことが起きているということと、それから昨年の都知事選は私は立候補はしなかったんですけど、立候補した中に 非正規で働いてた人が若い人が立候補したんですけど、一定の得票に届かなかったので供託金は全額没収されてしまいました。彼はその供託金をかなりの部分は借金で賄ってたんですね。だからその立候補をして、選挙自分なりの主張を一生懸命訴えたんですけど、その後その供託金を没収されてしまって、大変生活がしんどい状態に陥っているというようなことをお話しています。でその彼はその私たちのこの、供託金、違憲訴訟に非常に関心を持ってまして、傍聴にも来てまして、その、裁判終わった後の集会でそういう話をされてました。
I would like to speak of two examples from direct or personal experience in relation to this also, or close examples from recent years. If we consider the existence of the Green Party, which in many countries, for example, throughout Europe has a significant number of seats within various national parliaments, or in some countries' cases even is forming part of the government. There is also a Green Party which was founded in Japan in 2013 at the time of the House of Councillors election. They stood 10 candidates in for the proportional seats at the time of the election. However, when we consider that for each candidate, 6 million yen is required, therefore in order to have 10 candidates stand, the required number to stand for proportional seats. This meant that they were required to raise 60 million yen in order to stand in these House of Councillors elections. They were able to raise the deposits and therefore did stand their candidates. However, as they did not achieve the required number of seats to have this deposit returned to them after the election, this meant that this 60 million yen was actually confiscated after the election and not returned to them, which has meant that they were also not in the position to stand candidates in the House of Representatives election, which followed this, and also the elections of last year as well. So the fact that they had this huge amount of election deposit required at the time of the 2013 elections has meant that the Greens Party in Japan has not able to put forward any candidates in subsequent elections. The second example is from the Tokyo gubernatorial election of last year. I myself did not stand at that time. However, one particular young person who was working as a non-permanent worker or a temporary worker stood as a candidate in the Tokyo gubernatorial election. He was able to raise the election deposit, however, similarly was also not able to achieve the required number of votes or proportion of votes for this to be returned to him. He actually had relied quite significantly on loans for raising his election deposit, and as a result he is now working or in a very difficult position of trying to raise enough money to return these loans after having stood in election. He was standing in the election in order to make his political stance known and to make an appeal within politics. However, he is now in a very difficult circumstances in regards to his everyday life situation now as well. This particular individual is showing great interest in our lawsuit. He regularly comes to observe when we are in session and so on, and he has also spoken about his personal experiences at our related gatherings.
1点よろしいですか。
どうぞ。
先ほどの司会の方のご質問は、アメリカでは選挙供託金はないけれども他にいろいろなお金がかかりますよというお話でしたけれども、それはおそらく日本では、選挙に立候補すると、チラシ、ポスター新聞に載せたりと、そういったものが自費負担ではなくて国から出ているので、そのお金を一部自分で支払う必要があるのかどうかっていう質問の趣旨だと私は理解したんですけれども、それについてちょっとお話しさせてください。
So I would like to respond to Mr. McNeil's question in regards to, the example for example of the United States where there is no election deposit required, however various other funds and so on are required. I think that this may have also been in relation to the fact that for those candidates standing in election in Japan, the costs required, for example, for printing flyers, posters, newspaper advertisements, advertisements and so on. There is a system in place where the state provides the funds for some of this political advertising rather than the individual as well. So I think my understanding is that that question was probably in relation to this system of the election campaign and its funds.
日本では1948年から1952年まで4年間公営分担金制度というものがあって、選挙供託金3万円のほかに、自分の選挙費用の一部として2万円を支払う制度がありました。
In Japan, for the 4 years between 1948 and 1952, as part of the system of distribution of public funds, there was the system in place where the election deposit was set at 30,000 yen, but there was also a 20,000 yen required for costs related to your election campaign, which was also required during that period.
ですので、選挙費用を一部、候補者が自分で負担すべきだという制度があったんですけれども、それは、廃止されました。
So at that time there was a system in place where the candidates were required to pay for some of their election campaign fees themselves. However, this system was actually abolished after that.
廃止された理由は、選挙は、国が、行う義務があると。いうことで国が負担すべきものだという意見が強まったからです。
And the reason that this was abolished is because there was a strengthening of the opinion that, well, the election is run on the responsibility of the state and therefore the state should also be financially responsible for the election.
ですので現在の選挙供託金制度というものには、自分で選挙費を払うという意味が、もう含まれておりませんので司会者の方がおっしゃったようなご指摘のお金とはちょっと意味合いが違うということになります。
And therefore, or as a result of this system being abolished, this also means that the current election deposit does also not contain the purpose of funds to be used for election campaign purposes. This potential reason has been extracted as a result of the abolition of this system at that time as well. Therefore, within Mr. Munil's question, looking at whether these funds or the relationship between election campaigning costs, I do not think that it could be said that the election deposit funds are related to the actual campaign costs itself.
Thank you very much. We'll take one more question if somebody has a burning question they want to ask. Everybody satisfied with what they've heard? Well, I'm very curious about why there hasn't been more media attention in this issue, but maybe we can leave that for another day. Why, it does seem like quite an important issue and aPertains to democracy in Japan, so I'm quite puzzled at the lack of media interest in it today and in general.
司会の方からですね、この問題がなぜ あまりメディアで取り上げられていないのか、なぜあまり報道されないということなんですけれども、かなり日本の民主主義そのものにも関連してくる問題だと思いますので、ただそれは今日のこの時間でというよりも、また改めてできればと思います。
Well, thank you so much to Mr. Utsunomiya and Mr. Kamoda for coming along today and explaining this very important issue to us. Your fifth hearing is in September, and do you know when you can expect a ruling?
The next court is in September. We're not sure when the verdict will be given.
And of course, it's expensive to run a lawsuit as well, I imagine.
で、裁判そのものももちろんお金もたくさん必要だと思うんですけれども。
まあそれなんとかそれこそカンパ寄付で、賄ってます。
Yes, we are somehow able to raise the funds for this through again individual donations and contributions.
All right. それからこの裁判の中で、この裁判を担当している裁判官が一つは諸外国の供託金のゼロの国が非常に多いことを知ってですね、この裁判を担当する中で裁判官の認識がかなり変わって、すごく裁判官自身がこの裁判に関心を持つようになってきております。特に 前回の裁判でですね、国に対してしっかりとその原告の主張に対する反論を用意する、もちろん原告も主張を、我々も主張を追加しなきゃいけないんですけど、しっかりとした反論をするように、それは日本では実は OECD で22カ国も供託金がゼロの国があるっていうのは、このことは我々が調査して初めて日本で分かったことなんです。今まで全くこの事実自体が日本社会で一般的になかったんです。で、そういうことを知って裁判所がすごく関心を持ってきたと。それから日本の憲法学者でこの問題に詳しい、憲法学者一橋の忠野教授に意見書を書いてもらいまして、この憲法学者の意見書が素晴らしい意見書だったので、裁判所の方も本格的にこの問題を取り組もうという姿勢が我々の方からは伺えるようになったところですね。
The next court sitting will be in September. And one of the things we have also seen within this process as well, the process of this lawsuit is also increasing interest from the judges in relation to this issue as well. For example, through this lawsuit, they have learned for the first time about the fact that many other countries have zero election deposit, for example. And so as a result of introducing these examples from other countries, there has also been a significant increase in interest from the judiciary in Japan as well. And therefore, we have seen, particularly in the fourth session, we saw that the sitting or the judge was calling on the Japanese government side to put forward a strong or to prepare a strong argument in response to explain their position about this. Of course, we on our side will need to be adding information as well. But for example, the fact that 22 of the OECD member countries have no election deposit required is something that we also only learned for the first time as a process of this lawsuit. This is something which is not generally very much known or understood within Japan as well. And therefore, we are seeing that also there is an increase in public interest and also interest from the court in regards to this as well. Also, a very prominent Japanese constitutional scholar called Professor Tadano from Hitotsubashi University has provided an opinion for our lawsuit as well, which goes in great detail and is very much or very excellent piece as well, which has also led to greater interest from the courts as well.
Thank you so much. Well, we have to say goodbye because we're out of time. But we do hope that they win their case, of course, and we hope that when you do win your case, you'll come back and tell us all about it. Do show your appreciation for the two speakers today. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.